What is the smell in this room? Don't you notice it, Brick? Don't you notice a powerful and obnoxious smell of mendacity in this room?
Yes. Man?
There is nothing more powerful. Is there, Brick?
No, sir. No, there isn't. No, anything more obnoxious.
Brick agrees with me. The odor of mendacity is a powerful and obnoxious odor that the storm hasn't blown away yet. You notice it, Brick?
What, sir?
How about you, sister woman? You notice the unpleasant odor of mendacity in this room?
What, Big Daddy? I don't even know what that is.
You can smell it. Hell, it smells like death. What's wrong with you? You fat woman over there, loaded up with diamonds. Hey, what's your name? What's the matter with you?
You have a slight exposure to death.
You better watch that, Big Mama. A stroke is a bad way to go.
Oh, Rick. Big Daddy has on you. Birthday present to him. He has on your cashmere robe, the softest material I ever get.
Yeah, this is my soft birthday, Maggie. Not my gold or my silver birthday, but my soft birthday. The softest ever. Everything I got to be soft for Big Daddy on this birthday.
Big Daddy's got on the Chinese slippers that I gave him, Brick. Big Daddy, I haven't given you my present yet, but now I will. Now's the time to present. I have an announcement to make. What? What kind of announcement?
A sports announcement. Maggie?
Announcement of life beginning. A child is coming, sired by Brick and out of Maggie the cat. I have this child in my body, and that's my birthday present to Big Daddy on this birthday.
Girl, get up off your feet, girl. This girl has life in her body. That's no lie.
Big Daddy's dreams come true.
Jesus.
Son. I'm going up on the roof, to the God there on the roof, to look over my kingdom, before I give up my kingdom. 28,000 acres of the richest land here on the Valley Nile.
Sweetheart, can I come?
Brick, could you probably spare me one of those small shots of liquor? But still, man.
I won't be still. I know she made this up.
God damn it, I said shut up.
Gracious, I didn't know my little announcement would provoke such a storm.
That woman isn't pregnant.
Who said she was?
She did.
The doctor didn't. Dr. Bard didn't.
I haven't gone to doctor.
Then who do you go to, Maggie?
One of the best diamond parties in the
South. I see. Do we have his name?
No, you may not, Mr. Prosecuting Attorney.
He doesn't have a name. He doesn't exist.
Oh, he exists all right. And so does my child, Brick's baby.
You can't conceive a child by a name fall asleep with you, unless you've been here.
Turn that off.
We know it's a lie. We can hear you in here. He won't sleep with you. We can hear you. So don't think you gotta put this over on us and fool a dying man with a... Cooper, did you hear that?
Sounds like the man has struck. Come along, let these ladies' lovebirds get in their heads.
Liar.
That you're stronger than me, and I didn't want to be overpowered by you. But now, since you take it to look here, you know what? I guess it's bad. But now I'm stronger than you,
and I can love you more truly. Don't move that pillow. I'll move it right back into the brick. I really have been to the doctor, and I know what to do, and Rick, this is my time by the calendar to conceive.
Yes, I understand. But how can you conceive where a man can lower his liquor?
By locking up his liquor and making him satisfy my desires before I unlock it.
Is that what you have done, then?
Look and see. The cabinet's mighty empty to compare to before. And so tonight, we're going to make this light true. And when that's done, I'll bring the liquor right back here and we'll get my ticket here tonight, in this place, that death has come into me. What do you say?
I don't have anything to say.
Oh, you weak, beautiful people. You have such grace. What you want is someone to take hold of you, care for you, gently. With love, hand your life back to you like something golden and let go. I do love you, I do.
What would it be?
The end.